बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास अगेन। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल विथ योर फैमिली मेंबर्स। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक ए क्लास अबाउट द राइट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू विल बी बेनिफिटेड फ्रॉम माय क्लास। टुडे आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द डिफरेंट यूजेस ऑफ वर्ब्स in an actual form. Okay, first of all I am going to the first rule. When you will get any sentence of universal truth, that means chirantar satya, scientific truth or any other historical event, then we have to use V1 form of verb. Okay, clear my dear students? If you want to be very clear, then notice my example. I am writing the example of this rule. The sentence is, the example is, the stars twinkle in the sky. Here the sentence is universal truth, and here the verb is here twinkle. As the subject is third person plural number, we have used here twinkle, and this is a universal truth. The moon shines at night. Chand rate amuday. Here the verb is shine. Notice the example. Here the sentence is an universal truth. Okay, dear students, now I am going to the another example. Habitual. Now I will tell you about habitual fact. That means obhyasgata karma. I always take care of my parents. Here the verb is take care. That means jatno neva. Okay, dear students, think what I have told you. In the case of habitual fact, scientific truth or universal truth, historical event, then we have to use verb, V1 form of verbs. Okay, dear students, are you clear? Thank you very much. Now I am going to the another rule. Another rule is imperative sentence. Dear students, do you know about imperative sentence? Imperative sentence is such kind of sentence that means an order, an advice, a request, etc. Anugrahasuchak bakya. When you will get any imperative sentence, it must be started with the verb, the base form of verb. Okay, dear students, for example, do it at once. Here the verb is do. Okay, the verb is do. Let us play in the afternoon. These two sentences are imperative sentences. That is why in the first sentence I have used here the base form of verb do, and the next sentence I have used here play. Let us play in the afternoon. Okay, both the verb are in base form. Okay, now I am going to the another rule, optative sentence. Now I am telling you about optative sentence. In an optative sentence, we must use the base form of verb. Optative sentence, ichha athoba ashirbad suchok bakya, je sentence dara mone ichha ashirbad shubhkamona prokash kora hoy, that is called optative sentence. Are you clear, my dear students? Okay, let's let's see the example. May you be happy. May you be happy. Here is in the present form. May you live long. Here the verb is live. Okay. May Allah bless you. Here the verb is bless. These verbs are in the best form. Okay, dear students, now you are clear that in an optative sentence we always use V1 form of verb, best form of verb. Then I am going to the another rule. The another rule is when some adverbial phrase such as now, at this moment, today, at present, when we get this kind of adverbs, then we have to use verb plus ing. That means the continuous form of verbs, present perfect continuous tense. And in present perfect continuous tense, the structure is subject plus m oblique r oblique is plus verb plus ing plus object. Okay, dear students, now I am going to the example sentence. I am writing now. In this sentence, M is auxiliary verb and the main verb has been formed by adding ing. Okay, are you clear? I have used here M, then I have used here ing with the main verb. Okay, now I am going to tell you about the another example. He is taking rest at this moment. He is taking rest at this moment. Here the auxiliary verb is and ing, the ing form with the main verb take. Okay, the sentence is he is taking rest at this moment. Why I have used ing with the main verb? Because of at this moment, now. Are you clear? Now here, now at this moment, this is the these are the adverbial phrase. Okay, dear students, when we get this adverbial phrase, then we have to use ing with the main verb. ing with the base form of the main verb. Okay. Now I am going to the another rule. If there is no indication of times, but if you find some phrases or adverbs, what kind of phrases or adverbs? Now I am telling you about those kind of adverb, such as hardly, rarely, seldom, now and then, off and on, frequently, always, all the day, all the year round, all the regions, every day, every morning, every evening. This kind of adverb, if we get this kind of adverb, then we have to use V1 form of verbs. Okay, dear students, I hardly visit my village home. I hardly visit my village home. Notice this, here visit is in the form of V1 and hardly here is a adverb. Hardly means kadachit, not always, but sometimes. Okay. I water the plants What are the plants? What are the plants in every morning? Here in every morning is a phrase, and we have to use the base form of verb. Here in the sentence, the base form of verb is water. I water the plants in every morning. Are you clear, my dear students? For this phrase, in every morning, here the base form of verb water is used here, has been used here. And in the previous sentence, for hardly, for the adverb hardly, the verb here is visit, is in the base form of the verb. Okay, now I am going to tell you about another rule. If we get some adverbs such as just now, yet, already, lately, recently, ever, then we have to use V3 form of verbs. Dear students, notice my example. I have reached home just now. I have reached home just now. Here, oh, the auxiliary verb is have, and the principal verb is in the V3 form. That means past participle. Past participle form of verbs. And home and just now. Here, just now is the adverbial frame or adverbial phrase or adverb. For this adverb, just now, I have used here present perfect tense. After the auxiliary verb have or has, you have to use the V3 form of the main verb. Here, reached is the past participle form or V3 form. Okay. Just like this, if we get other adverbial phrase such as just, recently, lately, ever, yet, then we have to follow this rule. That means we have to use auxiliary verb have or has after subject, and the main verb will be past participle form. Okay, then I am going to tell you about some modal verb. Do you know modal verb? About modal verb? Yes, modal verb are those verbs that are can, could, shall, should, will, would, may, might, must. Modal verb plus V1 form of verbs. Okay, dear students. Now I am telling you about the modal verbs. The modal verbs are can, could, shall, should, will, would, may, might, must, let, dare, need, needn't, going to, able to, have to, has to, had to, must have, had better, would rather, would better. Would better, would rather is not modal verb. But if we get this kind of word, then you have to use V1 form of verb, dear students. Besides this, modal verb plus V1 form of verbs, such as you can share your knowledge. You can share your knowledge. Here, can is a modal verb, and share, bhagabhagi kora, share is in the form of V1. Okay, you have to use after modal verb, you have to use V1 form of main verb after the modal verb. Okay, dear students, are you clear? If you clear, then you have to practice by yourself. Dear students, today my class is finished now. I hope to see you in the next class. Till then, all of you will be okay by the grace of Almighty Allah. Okay, thank you very much.